Now, these are the components of managing self. These are the factors which determine how you can manage self. Emotional self-awareness, accurate self-assessment, self-confidence, emotional self-control, transparency, adaptability, achievement, initiative, and optimism. We'll briefly elaborate on each of these components of managing self. Emotional self-awareness is reading one's own emotions and recognizing their impact using gut sense to guide decision. Leaders high in emotional self-awareness are attuned to their inner signals, how their feelings affect them and their job performance. They are attuned to their guiding values and can often intuit the best course of action, seeing the big picture in complex situations. Emotionally self-aware leaders can be candid and authentic, able to speak openly about their emotions, or with conviction about their guiding vision. The most telling sign of self-awareness is propensity for self-reflection and thoughtfulness. And Goleman says that this is which many outstanding leaders cultivate in their spiritual lives. Propensity for self-reflection and thoughtfulness. हमने देखा है हमारे जो डे टू डे लाइफ में अपने बारे में सोचने का तो मौका ही नहीं मिलता है. What is happening to you, you don't know. Knowing one's strengths and limits. Knowing your strength and limits. तेते पांव पसारिए जेते लंबी सौर. Leaders with high self-awareness typically know their limitations and strengths and exhibit a sense of humor about themselves. Exhibit a sense of humor about themselves. They exhibit a gracefulness in learning where they need to improve, and welcome constructive criticism and feedback. Accurate self-assessment lets a leader know when to ask for help and when to focus in cultivating new leadership strengths. Self-confidence. Being sure of one's self-worth and capabilities. Self-confident leaders can welcome a difficult assignment. वही बात है, फूल रोकते कांटे हमें बढ़ाते. Give me difficult assignment. सवा लाख तें एक लड़ाऊं. Such leaders often have a sense of presence, a self-assurance that lets them stand out in a group. Next is self-control. Keeping disruptive emotions and impulses under control. Self-regulation is like an ongoing inner conversation. It frees us from being prisoners of our feelings. It's a remarkable statement. Once you know your feelings, you won't remain prisoner. It frees us from being prisoners of our feelings. Leaders with emotional self-control find ways to manage their disturbing emotions and impulses, and even to channel them in useful ways. A hallmark of self-control is the leader who stays calm, clear-headed, and under high stress or during crisis, or who remain unflappable even when confronted by a trying situation. Chitta vritti nirodha. There is entire, at least one, so many others, but Patanjali's Yoga Shastra is basically a book on self-control, self-assessment and self-control. People with quality of self-regulation also feel bad moods and emotional impulses. ऐसा नहीं होता कि उनको गुस्सा वगैरह नहीं आता या उनके मन में बुरी भावना नहीं उठती है. But they find ways to control them and channel them in useful ways. They roll with changes. They don't panic. Many of the bad things that happen are due to impulsive behavior. For example, opportunity of corrupt practice presents itself and people with low impulse control say yes. The bottom line is self-management. Swami Parthasarathi says, once you learn how to manage yourself, you can manage anything. You can manage time. You can manage work. You can manage productivity. You can manage stress, says Swami Parthasarathi. Transparency is another thing which Daniel Goleman finds on the basis of research as a very important element of managing self. Transparency means displaying honesty and integrity, trustworthiness. Leaders who are transparent live their values. Transparency and authentic openness to others about one's feelings, beliefs and actions allows integrity. Such leaders openly admit mistakes or faults and confront unethical behavior in others, then turn a blind eye. There is a lot of hullabaloo about transparency these days. What is remarkable is the finding that transparency is a competency that determines success of a leader. This could be argued, debatable. But this is what Daniel Goleman and his team, they find on the basis of research. And I feel that their research tallies well with my own gut feeling, with my own sense. Then adaptability. Flexibility in adapting to change situation or overcome obstacles. I quoted Charles Darwin in the beginning. Leaders who are adaptable can juggle multiple demands without losing their focus or energy and are comfortable with inevitable ambiguities of organizational life. Such leaders can be flexible in adapting to new challenges, nimble in adjusting to fluid change, and limber in their thinking in the face of new data or realities. It's something like धूप भी हमें कबूल, छांव भी हमें कबूल, हमने हर तरह के फूल हार में पिरो लिए। नेक्स्ट कंपोनेंट इज अचीवमेंट। अचीवमेंट इज ड्राइव टू इंप्रूव परफॉर्मेंस टू मीट इनर स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ एक्सीलेंस, टू मीट inner standards of excellence. ये नहीं कि हमारा सेल्स टारगेट 100 यूनिट्स का है इस दिन, वो अचीव कर लिया। गोल्डमैन इज नॉट टॉकिंग ऑफ दैट नैरो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अचीवमेंट। हमने सेट किया मॉर्निंग में कि आज दिन भर में 100 मक्खियां मारेंगे, तो मार लिया, तो सेंस ऑफ अचीवमेंट। नो, गोल्डमैन डजंट मीन दैट। दोज विथ लीडरशिप पोटेंशियल आर मोटिवेटेड बाय ए डीपली एम्बेडेड डिजायर टू अचीव फॉर द सेक ऑफ अचीवमेंट, नॉट बाय बिग सैलरी आर स्टेटस। सच लीडर्स हैव हाई पर्सनल स्टैंडर्ड्स that drive them to constantly seek performance improvements, both for themselves and those they lead. Constantly seek performance improvement as a teacher of yourself and of your students. They are pragmatic, setting measurable but challenging goals, and are able to calculate risk so that their goals are worthy but attainable. A hallmark of achievement is continually learning and teaching ways to do better. Continuously learning ways to do better. ये नहीं कि दिस वॉज द बेस्ट दैट कुड बी डन। पीटर ड्रकर सेड दैट द मोमेंट यू सेड दैट दिस इज द ओनली वे ऑफ डूइंग समथिंग देन यू मस्ट बी रॉन्ग। द फर्स्ट साइन इज अ पैशन फॉर द वर्क, पैशन फॉर द वर्क इटसेल्फ। अजीम प्रेमजी बिलीव्स इन वैल्यूज लाइक ऑनेस्टी, integrity, customer value, and innovation. But for him, passion is most important. And according to Anil Ambani, Reliance has a burning desire to achieve. Now this, now, I think Anil and Mukesh would still say the same thing. Okay? That their organizations, the people in their organizations, have burning desire to achieve. People with high motivation remain optimistic even when the score is against them. Self-regulation combines with achievement motivation to overcome the frustration and depression that come after a setback of failure. I am reminded of a shloka from Neet Shatak of Bhartrihari. You know, Bhartrihari was a great king, and great king. But something happened and he left everything. So there is a trinity of shataks. First is Shringar Shatak, विच इज अ बुक ऑन घोर श्रृंगार। आप पढ़ना शुरू करोगे तो छोड़ोगे नहीं उसको। किसी ने पढ़ा है श्रृंगार शतक? अच्छा, फिर उन्होंने नीत शतक लिखा एंड आफ्टर दैट ही रोट वैराग्य शतक। एंड आई बिलीव दैट दिस शुड बी ए बुक, टेक्स्ट बुक प्रिस्क्राइब्ड इन मॉडर्न मैनेजमेंट। ही क्लासिफाइज पीपल इन थ्री कैटेगरीज एंड आई रिमेम्बर द श्लोक प्रारभ्यते न खलु विघ्न भयेन नीचैः, प्रारभ्य विघ्न विहिता विरमन्ति मध्य विघ्नैः पुनः पुनः रपि प्रतिहन्यमानः, प्रारभ्य उत्तम जनाः न परित्यजन्ति। ये काम तो हो ही नहीं सकता, इतनी मुश्किलें इतनी परेशानियां हैं, तो बिगिन ही नहीं करते। ऐसे लोगों को भर्तृहर कहते हैं, नीच है। शुरू करते हैं काम, फिर बाद में परेशानियां आ गई तो छोड़ दिया। ऐसे लोगों को कहते हैं मध्यम। और उत्तम कौन है? जो सोच समझ के कोई काम प्रारंभ करते हैं और तब जाकर के संतुष्ट होते हैं जब अपने सफलता प्राप्त करते हैं। विघ्नैः पुनः पुनः रपि प्रतिहन्यमानः, प्रारब्ध च उत्तम जना न परित्यजन्ति। चाहे जितनी कठिनाइयां आए वो अपना उद्देश्य प्राप्त करके छोड़ते हैं। द नेक्स्ट कंपोनेंट इज इनिशिएटिव, रेडीनेस टू एक्ट एंड सीज अपॉर्चुनिटीज। लीडर्स हु हैव ए सेंस ऑफ एफिकेसी दैट दे हैव व्हाट इट टेक्स टू कंट्रोल देयर ओन डेस्टिनी एक्सेल इन इनिशिएटिव। दे सीज अपॉर्चुनिटीज आर क्रिएट देम रादर देन सिंपली वेटिंग। सच ए लीडर डज नॉट हेजिटेट टू कट थ्रू द रेड टेप or even bend the rules when necessary to create better possibilities for the future. Bend the rules when necessary to create better possibilities for the future. I think the example of Lord Krishna of Mahabharata is a classic example. वो धर्म की स्थापना के लिए आए हुए हैं लेकिन तमाम सारी मान्यताएं मर्यादाएं तोड़ते हैं। नेक्स्ट इज ऑप्टिमिज्म। ऑप्टिमिज्म इज सीइंग द अपसाइड इन इवेंट्स। ए लीडर हु इज ऑप्टिमिस्टिक can roll with punches, seeing an opportunity rather than a threat in a setback. In a setback, you see opportunity, not a threat. That is optimism. Such leaders see others positively, expecting the best of them. And their glass half full outlook leads them to expect that changes in the future will be for the better. पानी उतना ही है, एक कहता है कि ग्लास आधा भरा है, दूसरा कहता है आधा खाली है। जो कहता है भरा है वो उसका एटीट्यूड ऑप्टिमिस्टिक है। यहां पे एक बहुत फेमस साइकेट्रिस्ट हैं डॉक्टर वेज, उन्होंने ये शेर कोट किया था कभी, मौत कितनी भी संग दिल होगी, जिंदगी से तो रहम दिल होगी। जो ऑप्टिमिस्टिक हैं, जो इमोशनली इंटेलिजेंट हैं, वो ये कभी नहीं कहे। कि मौत चाहे जितनी संग दिल हो जिंदगी से तो बेटर होगी, ठीक है? नहीं, ऐसा कभी नहीं कहेंगे। दे वुड रादर से, आई कोट नीरज, अंगार अधर पर धर में मुस्काया हूं, मैं मरघट से जिंदगी बुला लाया हूं, हूं आंख मिचौनी खेल चुका किस्मत से, सौ बार मृत्यु के गाल चूम आया हूं, ठीक है? दैट इज ऑप्टिमिस्टिक अप्रोच। What is the time frame, Raksav? There would be some discussion also. मेरे ख्याल से कल, अच्छा ठीक है, अभी है थोड़ा सा है, क्विकली करूंगा। I would give you an exercise, not to do here, you can do it at home. Test your self-management competence on a 5-point scale. ये एक्सरसाइज वो भी कराएंगी, मीना सहगल भी कराएंगी जहां तक अपने लास्ट, हाँ, but this is a brief one, she might have a longer questionnaire, तो इससे उसको टैली करना। you understand this scale? If you think that you are very low on a particular criterion, then you put -2. I am reasonably constrained by the technology. There are 9 components, so you add all these scores and divide that by 9. If it's below 0, then you are low on that scale, and if it is above 0, then you are high, and so on. You can interpret it. I'm sure all of you would be in the +1 and +2 category. This is my belief. But honestly assess yourself, don't disclose it, don't discuss it, and then you will know your area where you should strengthen more, because this self-management competency can be learned and improved. The questions are obvious. How aware you are of your own emotions, how accurately you assess yourself, how confident you are of yourself, how good you are in controlling your emotions, how transparent you are, how well you can adapt to the changing situations, how much you are motivated by achievement for achievement's sake, not by salary or status, how good you are in taking initiative, how optimistic you are.
next slide.
I move to the next slide. Now, this is again an old story. It is story of hare and the tortoise. You know the race between the two. I retell you that story. The tortoise, slow but steady, had won the race. But the story goes beyond that. What's the story beyond that? The defeated hare went home and started thinking. I run so fast and the tortoise is so slow. Still I lost the race. Why? He analyzed the events and discovered the reason of his defeat. What was the reason? He understood that he was not steady. So what is the solution? He practiced to be steady. After sufficient practice, he went to the tortoise and proposed, "Let us run the race again." The tortoise agreed. They ran again. अब क्या होगा? This time the hare was steady and of course fast, so he won the race. The moral of the story is, fast and steady wins the race. Not slow and steady wins the race. Fast and steady wins the race. But the story doesn't end there. Now the tortoise went home and thought, I had won the race first, but lost this time, why? And he found the answer. Naturally, he could not match the speed of the hare, and the hare had become steady now. So the tortoise realized that now he cannot win the race with the hare. Nonetheless, his desire to win remained. सभी चाहते हैं जीतना. In fact, it became more intense. He thought, and he did find a way out. A race on a different path. He thought of the route and went to the hare and asked him if they could run a race along the new route. The overconfident hare readily agreed. So they ran again. The hare was fast and steady. He left the tortoise behind. The hare left the tortoise behind. But there was a river on this route. So he reached the river bank much ahead of the tortoise. But unable to swim, he sat on the bank, helpless, not knowing what to do. The tortoise, in the meantime, plodded along and reached the river. He entered the river, swam across, and reached the destination first. He had won the race again. So what is the moral of this story? If you cannot win under the existing rules of the game, change the rules of the game if you can. The tortoise was able to change the rules of the game. The business organizations, they try to change the rules of the games. Aajkal to rozana examples aate hain. But the story doesn't finish there. By now, both the tortoise and hare had known each other well. And people say that ladies are emotionally more intelligent than men. So, देयर वाइव्स हैड बिकम फ्रेंडली, आपस में उनमें भी दोस्ती हो गई. द वाइव्स डिस्कस्ड एंड डिसाइडेड टू एडवाइज देयर हस्बैंड्स. व्हाई नॉट देयर हस्बैंड्स कोऑपरेट एंड कंबाइन देयर कोर कॉम्पिटेंसीज एंड देन रन मर्जर्स एंड एक्विजिशंस. The husbands obeyed like good husbands do. So first the tortoise sat on the back of the hare ran fast and steady. They reached the river bank quickly. Then the hare sat on the back of the tortoise swam across the river. They both reached their goal effectively and efficiently. So what is the moral of this story? The moral of this story is, if you really want to win, learn to manage relationships, learn to build bonds, learn to cooperate, learn to collaborate, and managing self is sine qua non. And the story begins. And the story begins. Uttishthat jagrat prapti varanya bodhat kshurasya dhara nishita dudatya durgam pathastat kavayo vadanti. Arise, awake and achieve excellence. The way to excellence goes via managing self, which can be learned and enhanced. Arise, awake and achieve. And learned people say that the way is not easy, it's difficult. That's what it means. Jaise churi ki dhaar pe chalna hai, us tarah se hai raasta. The way to excellence goes via managing self, which can be learned, which can be enhanced through training and practice. Although it is not easy. Those of you who have read Gita would remember, Arjun tells Krishna, Chanchalam himanah Krishna pramath valvadranam nigraham manne tasya vayu royu sudushkara. Man bada chanchal hai. Isko control karna utne mushkil hai jaise hawa ki dhar, vayu ki dhar की दिशा बदलना हो. तो अर्जुन कहते हैं कि निसंदेह महाबाहो है तो मुश्किल, लेकिन योग और अभ्यास से कंट्रोल में लाया जा सकता है. सो ट्रेनिंग एंड 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 ट्रेनिंग एंड मेडिटेशन आर द वेज. Now, finally, I would like to become a little personal. How do I learn? Now, this is a story of self, and you can get a lesson from it if you want to. Every morning, I get up around 5 o'clock, and then up to nearly 8 o'clock, I am with myself. Ye minimum hai, 2 ghanta, 2.5 ghante ka. Every morning, I sit relaxed. I force myself to be relaxed. Move each limb and feel relaxed. I have developed my own system of acupressure and yoga. And I pray every morning. Ye sara sab saath mein chalta hai. What is my prayer? Some part of prayer. Om Sahana Vavatu Sahano Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karvavahai Tejas Yunavadhita Mastu. Theek hai, 5 minutes mein ho jayega. Please. I'll finish it. Hopefully I'll finish it. ओम सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति शांति शांति. गॉड प्रोटेक्ट अस टुगेदर, नरिश अस टुगेदर, वी टुगेदर परफॉर्म ब्रेव डीड्स, आवर स्टडीज बी फुल ऑफ ब्रिलियंस, वी नॉट बी जेलस ऑफ ईच अदर. दिस प्रेयर emphasizes cooperation, work together, and I pray for that every morning. Om Ano Bhadra Krito Yantu Vishwata. Let virtues come from everywhere in the universe. Vishwani Deva Savitar Duritani Pararsu Bhadram Tanna Asu. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Let evils go away and virtues come to us. ओम सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्. द 5 minutes रिस्ट्रिक्शन इज गोइंग कंट्रेरी टू व्हाट आई शुड डू, बट आई विल डू दिस. लेट ऑल बी हैप्पी एंड हेल्थी, लेट एवरीबडी फाइंड वर्चूज एंड लेट देयर बी नो सफरिंग. असतो मा सद्गमय, तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्योर्मामृतं गमय. सत्यम वद धर्मम चर स्वाध्यायन मा प्रमद. ईशावास्यम इदम सर्वम यत किंच जगत्यांग जगत तेन तक्तेन भुंजी था माग्धा कस्य सिद्धनम. देहु शिवा वर्मो ही है शुभ कर्मं तय कबो न टरो. ओम देव शांति अंतरिक्ष शांति एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. Peace on cosmos, on sky, on earth, on waters, on plants and herbs. Peace for all. Peace for all gods and Brahma. Peace always, everywhere. Only peace. And peace for me as well. And so on. And I pause in between. I repeat silently each mantra and then pause. I watch my breath. And at least during that period, it becomes rhythmic. You must learn to watch your breath if you have already not learned it. Automatically, you will be able to manage self better. In fact, I believe that each morning chore is an effective workshop on managing self. I look at Srimad Bhagavad Gita. It is, as it appears to me, an excellent treatise on managing self. Maybe the scope and... Anyway, that's not important. I look at Ramcharitmanas as a possibly an excellent text on managing self. It is Nana Puran Nigmagam Sammatam. And the most important line from here is, Tulsidas prays Lord Rama's face. Prasannatam yanna gatabhishekata sthu na mamale vanabas dukhata. Raj milne ke nate chehre pe harsh nahi rata. Ha ha, mujhe raj mil gaya. Aur jab raj jata hai, to chehre pe zara bhi dukh nahi hai. That is managing self. I read Kabir, Guru Kumar Shishkumbh hai, Gadi Gadi Kaat hai, quote. And I, that is my ideal of a teacher. Godhan Gajdhan Baljdhan Aur Ratandhan Khan. I read Guru Nanak and Guru Gobind Singh, Jesus Christ. In fact, if the 5 minutes restriction was not there, I would tell you the story of Jesus Christ. And Muhammad Sahib. You know, there was a lady who, she hated Muhammad Sahib. तो सुबह जिस रास्ते जाते थे उसके घर से जाते थे, ऊपर छत पर से उनके ऊपर कूड़ा फेंक देती थी वो, और वो चले जाते थे. एक दिन उसने कूड़ा नहीं फेंका तो मोहम्मद साहब को ताज्जुब हुआ कि क्या हुआ. तो he went up to find out the welfare of that lady. That's Muhammad Sahib. और जीसस क्राइस्ट क्रॉस पे टंगे हुए हैं और तब भी जिन्होंने उनको क्रॉस पे टांगा हुआ है उनको उनके लिए भगवान से माफी मांगते हैं। इस तरह की कहानी रामचरितमानस में भी है। सो फ्रेंड्स, ऑल द बेस्ट। मुझसे तू अविरत कहता जा, मुंह से तू अविरत कहता जा मधु मदिरा मादक हाला, हाथों में अनुभव करता जा एक ललित कल्पित प्याला, ध्यान किए जा मन में सुमधुर सुंदर सुखकर साकी का, और बढ़ा चल पथिक न तुझको दूर लगेगी मधुशाला। ऑल द बेस्ट, थैंक्स फॉर द पेशेंट हियर।